too hot. Hot radio. Radio. Too hot. Hot radio. Radio. Radio.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is. It's what y'all been waiting for. Get ready.
Let us know about this new project, this new album.
Right now, 8 Ways Entertainment, that's my label, 8 Ball, you know what I'm talking about, doing it myself and things. 8 Ways Entertainment, we got this album, Light Up the Bomb. It's kind of like a family album, you know what I'm saying? I got all my artists, Devious, his album will be out in March. Me and him, we all over the album, you know.
Okay, and what's going to be the first single, and are we going to be able to see a video for that? Is this a separate venture from the whole Bad Boy deal?
This is my own label. This is 8 Ball's label. You know, Bad Boy is Sean P. Diddy's label, and 8 Ways is 8 Ball's label.
So you stepping out and bossing up, and you've been doing this whole rap thing for a while. But tell the people how long you've been doing 8 Ways and trying to get your artist out there.
I really got started a few years ago with a couple of me and MJ's projects and an album called The Spray Off, and we just kind of record my albums almost dangerously. Thank you for helping, you know what I'm saying? But we just kind of, you know, I just kind of laid off that for a little while, and I'm back in the league right now. I got a squad, you know, and I got not only a squad, but just plans of just doing more than just hip-hop and rap music. I'm going to definitely be a hip-hop label. I want to try to do a little bit of everything.
How do you like that position of a CEO?
Just like everything else, man. I mean, it's just like really every other position, but if you don't do your work, it's gonna show. You know, if you're an artist or whatever, if you're not working hard trying to make your craft the best that it could be, then it's gonna show. You know what I'm saying? And the same thing go with a CEO. If you're a CEO and you're not working hard to market the product, it's definitely gonna show.
Many people might assume with your success that 8 Ball can just walk into any radio station and have his album played or have his artist played. Is it like that, or explain the process to us?
It's like that to a certain extent, because, you know, me being who I am, certain places I can just walk up in there and get my shit, get myself played, but, like, still, the game, you know, the game has evolved into pretty much, you know, you gotta get them shots sometimes, no matter who you are, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
You know, you gotta play the game, no matter who you are, you know.
With all your success, can you still catch the Memphis City Blues? And do you still consider yourself almost famous, even though most of us see you as a living legend?
Yeah, because Memphis City Blues is not a feeling or a sense. It's something in you, and it don't mean nothing bad. It's just something that you have. You know what I mean? Being from Memphis, man. Like, as far as being almost famous, you know, I'll explain that again. You know, when I said I was almost famous in that title of that album, I just mean, like, I was almost to the top or halfway to the top. I mean, like, you know, I'm going to forever be how I am. I'm never going to be the industry definition of what famous is, man. Like, you know, I'm going to always be me.
We don't really see or hear hear any beef with, you know, 8-Ball or MJG, and, you know, you guys aren't really, it's almost like you're in the industry, but you're, you know, you still got that underground, that street cred. How did you guys keep that reputation and that respect?
We're not threatened by nobody because we kind of got our own lane. We kind of got our own thing. We do what 8-Ball and MJG do, you know, and cats get into all this beef when they get threatened by another person with, you know, they like somebody being paid what they got or whatever, you know. That's when the beef starts.
Because y'all always take your time to do a project, you know, it's not like it has to be every year or every 6 months. Outside of rap, what do you have going on business-wise?
We got a couple of other things, but, like, music and entertainment, that's kind of like the only thing that I do. You know, like, I'll forever be doing something that I can do with music or entertainment. We can move over to movies and soundtracks and stuff like that next year. So, you know, we got a couple of Streets of the Street DVDs coming out, and we're working on a movie. I'll be able to talk about it later on in the year, about the title and all that, but I mean, it's, you know, we're forever working on music and entertainment, man. That's my life. That's what I do, bro.
Any shows you got lined up where the people can catch you at?
We actually going to be in Baltimore the day after Thanksgiving. That's our next show. And then host party in Detroit, December 8th. And I don't know the words right now. Like, that's all I know off the top of my head. But all you got to do is go to www.8daysent.com, and usually we'll have our like show listers successors on that website.
Are you enjoying doing it yourself? And are we going to see, or when are we going to see, because I know we're going to see another 8-Ball and MJG album, and is it going to be on Bad Boy?
The new 8-Ball and MJG album will be out February the 13th. It's called Ride High. It's on Bad Boy. It's, you know, Bad Boy South, man.
Yeah, y'all holding it down. The P.